I'm Andrew Cohen, and I'm honored to be partnering with Humanity's team for Global Oneness Day. So the theme is oneness, and I thought I would just like to spend maybe 2 minutes just speaking about what oneness is. Usually when mystics, sages, and spiritual teachers talk about the whole notion of oneness, they're speaking about the ultimate nature of reality. And they tell us that in the mystical vision, they have an insight or a realization that the ultimate truth is that there's only one and there's not two. And I also, in my own experience, have discovered that this is true. But I also discovered that the nature of oneness moves in two directions simultaneously. And that's kind of it's an interesting way to think about it. So one notion of oneness is the very popular idea of the power of now, which is the experience that we have if we enter into very deep states of meditation. And if you enter into a very deep state of meditation, the thought process begins to fall away. And when the thought process begins to fall away, the awareness of time begins to fall away. And when the awareness of thought and time fall away, our awareness of the world around us begins to disappear. And when thought, time, and world disappear, if we keep on going ever more deeply into this kind of experience, even our awareness of our body will disappear. And so when thought, time, world, and form disappear, we realize, as all the great mystics have, that we're still here. But what's left is our essence, is our spiritual essence. And what we notice there is that our deepest, most intimately felt I sense, our deeply and most intimately felt sense of self, actually transcends and is always free from identification with the body and identification with our historical personality. And this is the perennial experience of mystical freedom, or what I call traditional enlightenment. It's the realization and recognition that the deepest part of ourself has never been born and never entered the stream of time. And the Buddha called this deepest dimension of self the unborn and the uncreated. So often when mystics are speaking about oneness or the ultimate truth of oneness, they're pointing to the deepest dimension of the self and the deepest dimension of reality itself. And the deepest dimension of the self that has never been born and never entered the stream of time is synonymous with and one with and identical with that primordial, timeless, formless, empty void from which the entire universe sprang forth 14 billion years ago. So the material universe, the manifest universe, emerged from nothing whatsoever. And when you enter into a very deep state of meditation, so deep that everything disappears and all that's left is your spiritual essence, that you'll notice that the nature of your spiritual essence is infinite. And that infinite ground is one with the emptiness, the primordial void from which the entire universe sprung. So one definition of oneness is identification with this primordial empty void, which is the deepest dimension of the self, and which, when we enter into meditative awareness, we recognize to be always our most intimately felt sense of self. And that most intimately felt sense of self, we realize, is your most intimately felt sense of self and everybody's most intimately felt sense of self and ultimately all sentient beings' most intimately felt sense of self. So that would be one definition of what the whole mystical notion of oneness is all about. But there's also, interestingly enough, another definition of oneness that I've discovered, which is that out of this primordial emptiness, out of this eternal void, sprang forth the creative process. And the creative process, another word for the creative process, is evolution. The entire evolutionary process, the entire evolving cosmos emerged from this primordial void. And as highly evolved human beings, you know, we experience that same creative impulse or evolutionary impulse as our urge towards creativity and innovation. The human species are the only life forms that are driven, or compelled to create and give rise to that which is new. So out of that primordial void, out of that primordial emptiness, emerge forth in the most dramatic form, in the most dramatic fashion, what we could choose to describe as a desire to exist in time and in form. And so I see and recognize the entire creative process as a desire to exist. Evolution, the evolutionary process, human beings also can experience as a desire to exist, because very creative people experiencing a great sense of ecstatic inspiration in their creativity. And so that which is driving very creative people to give rise to that which is new is that drive is one with the energy and intelligence, the creative force behind the entire cosmos. And so when we recognize this, we see the entire creative process, you know, from all the way from the evolution of the cosmos to the evolution of life, to the evolution of human culture, to the evolution of human consciousness, all as the manifestation of one singular creative process. And when we not only realize this intellectually and philosophically, but we actually also awaken to this truth spiritually, we directly experience the absolute or non-dual or singular nature of that creative drive or creative impulse. And what the experience of it is one of an ecstatic inspiration and an overwhelmingly positive life aspiration to create and give rise to that which is new through the vehicle of this body, this mind, and this physical form. So oneness, in this case, you know, the meaning and the definition of oneness actually means two things, really. It means awakening to the deepest part of ourselves that has never been born and never entered the stream of time. So we're awakening to that primordial foundation of everything that exists, and the primordial foundation of everything that exists is timeless and formless. And there's another definition of oneness, which is that the entire manifest creative process, all of evolution from matter to life to mind and everything that exists emerged out of that, and awakening to the energy and intelligence that's driving that process is also another experience of mystical or absolute oneness. And ultimately, these two manifestations and expressions of oneness are not separate. You know, one we could call being, the other would be called becoming. And ultimately, being and becoming are both expressions of oneness. And ultimately, both being and becoming are one and not two. So, it's a very interesting and endlessly fascinating subject. It's one I've given my life to, and I hope you can think a little bit about these few words. Thank you very much.